Firm handshake. The Cadillac CTS-V. Manual or automatic. That's entirely up to you. We don't just make luxury cars. We make Cadillacs.
Stop your doors at the hinge with Smart Stop. Doors damage walls. Other door stops damage doors and moldings. Only Smart Stop stops the door at the hinge with no damage to anything. Get Smart Stop now at the Home Depot.
7 First Alert Traffic is brought to you by Wallside.com. Shop at home and schedule a free in-home estimate. Visit Wallside.com today.
Well, tomorrow is a big test in the Republican race for president. We're talking about Super Tuesday.
And one way to gauge voters' concerns and interests is to look at what they're searching for online.
Yeah, joining us live now this morning from New York is Abby Tatton from Google's elections team with some insight into what's trending. Good morning, Abby.
Good morning. How are you?
We're doing well. Looking forward to tomorrow. I can only imagine when you're studying trends how much there is to study. Out of all the things that you guys have found, what do you think is one of the most interesting trends so far heading into tomorrow?
Well, I think looking at what issues people across the country are searching for has been pretty revealing. If we look at Michigan and really across the country, the top thing that people are searching out are searches around the economy. What we mean is unemployment, deficit, debt, bankruptcy. These kind of themes keep coming up over and over again in searches, far outweighing things like national security or social issues.
How about the Super Tuesday states? There are 10 states that would be voting tomorrow in primaries and caucuses. Any candidate leading the searches in those states?
Well, this is always interesting to look at, right? What is the candidate, which is the candidate at most at the front of people's minds as they head to the polls? And right now we're seeing a spike in searches for Rick Santorum in the few days heading into Super Tuesday. And that's really across the board. In 9 out of 10 of those states, he leads search. And that's been something that we've seen trending throughout this. It was Mitt Romney at the beginning, and then Rick Santorum really getting voters interested as we move through the cycle.
Is there anything in regards to a search for positive or negative when it comes to typing in a candidate's name?
Well, this is always something interesting to look at, right? You're not just searching on a candidate. Maybe you're putting in another search term as well. And is that something positive, like a policy or how many delegates they have? Or is it something more to do with a scandal? When we look at this, it's the candidate Ron Paul who's out and out in front in terms of positive searches. And then you look at Mitt Romney, Rick Santorum, and some of the attacks coming from either side are resonating in searches that people are doing across America.
How about videos, some of the political ads or videos related to their campaign stops? Any of those really popular?
Yeah, well, in general, the GOP candidates have been putting out their candidate ads on YouTube, and they've been viewed more than 40 million times so far this cycle. Think about that. That's more than 40 million times that voters have actively gone out and wanted to watch a candidate ad on YouTube. We traditionally thought of YouTube as a place where Democrats have really done well, and the GOP's really come back there. In terms of the most viewed ad from one of these candidates right now, it's an attack ad. You can see the negativity come through there. It's a Ron Paul attack ad on Newt Gingrich. But still, the most viewed candidate video of all time is from the president, Barack Obama, from last cycle. I think it's actually a video of him dancing on the show Ellen. Very popular on YouTube. Political video coming in all shapes and sizes.
Yeah, we were just showing a clip from that. And he had some moves.
Abby Tatton from Google in regards to searches heading into Super Tuesday. We appreciate that insightful information. We'll see it all shakes out tomorrow.